Hello student, today I am going to start digestion and absorption of food stuffs. The term digestion may be defined as the process of biochemical transformation of complex and larger food particles in the gut enzymatically into a simple form which is suitable for absorption. Digestion is carried out by the so many enzymes. One digestive juice digests up to a certain stage and further digestion is carried out by the next enzymes, and in this way the process goes on to completion. Now digestion of carbohydrates. The diet of most of the countries includes 60 to 80% of carbohydrates. Carbohydrate eaten mostly as the oligosaccharides or polysaccharides and to a lesser extent monosaccharides. Daily intake of carbohydrate ranges from 300 to 800 grams per day in adult, which generally supplies 1000 to 2500 calories. Forms of carbohydrates. Polysaccharides. It includes starch, dextrin, glycogen and cellulose. Next, oligosaccharides. It includes lactose, maltose, sucrose. And third one is the monosaccharides, which includes glucose and fructose. Digestion of polysaccharides and oligosaccharides start in the saliva and is completed in the succus entericus. Digestion of oligosaccharides chiefly takes place in the succus entericus. Now, digestion in the saliva. Saliva contains salivary amylase or ptyalin and trace of maltase. Salivary amylase acts on starch and hydrolyzes them to maltose and other glucose polymers. Ptyalin acts on boiled starch only. It can't penetrate the intact cellulose covering of the unboiled starch. A strong acid destroys ptyalin. Now digestion of carbohydrate in the gastric juice. Gastric juice does not possess any carbohydrate splitting enzymes, but gastric HCl can carry on some hydrolysis of sucrose. The acid gastric juice inhibits action of salivary amylase. But prior to this, nearly 30 to 40% of starch is already hydrolyzed. Digestion in pancreatic juice contains various enzymes that acts on carbohydrates. Pancreatic amylase. It can act on both boiled and unboiled starch. It acts more fast than ptyalin, and most of the starch convert into maltose within a few minutes. Amylase is not present in the pancreatic juice of infant up to the age of about 6 months. So, during this period, the baby should not be given any starchy food. The pancreatic amylase digests starch into maltose within 20 to 30 minutes as chymes enter into the duodenum. Now, role of intestinal glands in digestion. The enterocyte in a small intestinal mucosa contains digestive enzymes, peptidase, sucrase, maltase, lactase and intestinal lipase. Succus entericus contains oligo 1,6-glucosidase, which splits अल्फा 1-6 ग्लूकोसाइडिक लिंकेज ऑफ डेक्सट्रिन फॉर्म बाय द एक्शन ऑफ अल्फा एमाइलेज एंड अल्फा एमाइलेज एक्टिविटी कन्वर्ट्स आइसोमाल्टोज इनटू ग्लूकोज. माल्टेज कन्वर्ट माल्टोज टू ग्लूकोज. सो द स्टार्च इज कंप्लीटली हाइड्रोलाइज्ड टू ग्लूकोज बाय जॉइंट एक्शन ऑफ अल्फा 1-4 एमाइलेज प्रेजेंट इन सलाइवा एंड पैनक्रियाटिक जूस एंड अल्फा 1-6 ग्लूकोसाइडेज एंड माल्टेज इन द सक्कस इंटेरिकस. सुक्रेज एक्ट्स ऑन सुक्रोज प्रोड्यूसिंग फ्रक्टोज एंड ग्लूकोज. लैक्टेज एक्ट्स ऑन लैक्टोज गिविंग ग्लूकोज एंड गैलेक्टोज. नाउ फेट ऑफ ग्लूकोज इन द बॉडी. 5% स्टोर्ड एज ग्लाइकोजन इन द लिवर एंड मसल्स. 50-60% कैटाबोलाइज्ड इन ऑल टिश्यू टू प्रोड्यूस एनर्जी फॉर द बॉडी एंड 30-40% कन्वर्ट्स टू फैट एंड इज स्टोर्ड इन द बॉडी. नाउ डाइजेशन ऑफ प्रोटीन. द प्रोटीन्स आर एब्जॉर्ब्ड इन द फॉर्म ऑफ एमिनो एसिड्स. So the proteins are digested to amino acid prior to their absorption. Adults require 0.5 to 0.8 grams of proteins per kg of body weights per day to remain in the nitrogen balance, and growing child requires more proteins, that means 4 grams per kg of body weight per day. Now the forms of proteins, mostly albumin and globulins, nucleoproteins, casinogens, collagen and gelatins, mucin and elastin. Now the digestion of protein in the mouth, almost nil. In stomach, pepsin is proteolytic enzymes of the gastric juice. It hydrolyzes the bond between aromatic amino acid. Protein is converted to protease and peptone, which is digestible with the help of pepsin and the HCl. Caseinogens, which is milk protein and water insoluble, is converted into soluble casein with the help of renin in mammals and pepsin in humans, and again converted into the coagulants of calcium casein with the help of calcium salt. Now digestion of protein in small intestine. The proteolytic enzyme of pancreas involves in the digestion of proteins are the trypsin, chymotrypsin, elastase and carboxypeptidase. Endopeptidase are converted from their inactive form into active form in intestinal lumen by enterokinase enzyme. So trypsinogen is converted to trypsin with the help of enterokinase, and chymotrypsin is converted to chymotrypsin with the help of trypsin, and chymotrypsin coagulates milk like renin. It also hydrolyzes casein and gelatin. Further breakdown of protein is carried out by the exopeptidase, that means aminopeptidase, carboxypeptidase, tripeptidase and dipeptidase. These enzymes acts upon different fraction of digested protein molecule. Now aminopeptidase splits off those amino acid from the polypeptide molecules which possess a free amino group. Carboxypeptidase takes away those one which possess a free carboxyl group. Tripeptidase and dipeptidase splits off tri and dipeptides to amino acids. And pancreatic juice also contains two protein splitting enzymes, namely elastase and collagenase. Now, digestion of nucleoprotein. The proteolytic enzymes pepsin and trypsin hydrolyzes nucleoproteins into their protein and nucleic acid component. Protein is digested as protein digestion, and nucleic acids are depolymerized by hydrolytic action of pancreatic ribonuclease and deoxyribonuclease, with the production of oligonucleotides and certain pyrimidine mononucleotides. Oligonucleotides are converted to mononucleotides by intestinal phosphodiesterase. The mononucleotides are hydrolyzed by non-specific phosphatase and produce nucleosides and inorganic phosphate. Now, digestion of lipids. There are different forms of the lipid taken in the diet, is the neutral fats, phospholipids, cholesterols, free cholesterols, fatty acid and glycerol. Neutral fats are digested into fatty acids and glycerol. Hydrolysis of fat takes place in the stages. In the first stage, there is formation of one molecule of fatty acid and a diglyceride. Again, this diglyceride is break down into another molecule of fatty acid and monoglyceride. And again, this monoglyceride is finally hydrolyzed into another molecule of fatty acid and glycerol. So, the fat molecules after complete hydrolysis give rise to three molecules of fatty acid and one molecule of the glycerol. Now, the digestion of fat or lipid in the mouth. Saliva contains a small quantity of lingual lipase, so less than 10% of the fat digested in the mouth. Digestion of fat starts in the stomach and in the succus entericus. Now, the digestion of lipids in the gastric juice. It breaks neutral fat into one molecule of glycerol and three molecules of the fatty acid. It acts best in slightly acidic medium but is destroyed by 0.02% HCl in 15 minutes. Hence, its action takes place only in the initial stage of gastric secretion, when the acidity in the stomach is not high. Gastric lipase is a weak fat splitting enzyme. It acts at an optimal pH 4 to 4.5 and inactivated at pH 2.5. So it gastric lipase not work properly in the acidic medium. It acts based on emulsified fat, that is the egg yolk, milk, etc. Hydrolysis of fat in a stomach is not significant since most of the ingested fat is found in the duodenum, and the presence of lipase in the stomach is the by way of the regurgitation from the small intestine. Now, digestion of lipids in a small intestine. Fat digestion is mainly carried out in the duodenum by the pancreatic lipase. Pancreatic lipase hydrolyzes dietary fat molecules, converting triglycerides, substrates of food, to monoglycerides and free fatty acid. Since fat is insoluble, so pancreatic lipase acts on triglyceride in emulsified form in the lumen by bile salts into smaller droplets from large fat droplets. After breakdown in smaller droplets, there is increase in the overall surface area of the fat. Emulsification of fat takes place by bile salts, fatty acid, cholesterol, monoglycerides and proteins. Fatty acid and monoglyceride pass into micelle's phases with bile salts and they are converting to water soluble. The formed monomers moves by way of peristalsis along the small intestine and get absorbed into the lymphatic system by the lacteal. Thank you.